Ah, you know the feeling. You're in a familiar place, but everything's a little off. A stranger is chasing you. Street signs look like gibberish. You'd normally go for your phone, but it's nowhere to be found. You're in a dream, and here's why it's so different from reality. What are dreams anyway? It's basically your mind trying to reconstruct reality and failing. In dreams, everything gets mixed around and turned into a mess by our hidden thoughts and feelings. It's the emotional side of your brain constructing this world, not the logical part that's more in control of your waking life. So, why don't we ever see our smartphone in dreams? Well, the same goes for cars and other tech. When you dream, the props come from those older parts of the human mind that refer more to genetic memory than to your own. Both smartphones and cars came into our lives in relatively recent times, and our brains just haven't gotten used to them enough. Also explains why around 12% of people dream in black and white. And this is hardly ever the case with people younger than 25. Many of those who grew up with black and white television have dreams that are also monochromatic. One study in the 40s showed that 75% of young people back then saw most of their dreams in shades of gray. Why can't you write or read a message? The two regions of your brain that help you interpret language are mostly inactive when you're asleep. It's a good trick to know that you're in a dream. Try to read a book or tell the time on a clock. You won't be able to do it. In fact, are you sure you or other people are actually speaking? Communication in dreams is more often like telepathy. Plus, you always get that weird echo, kind of like this. The people you meet in dreams can't be strangers. That unknown person chasing you, you've seen them before. Might have even been a brief encounter sharing the elevator with a stranger. You couldn't bother to remember all those faces, but your brain does and uses them to fill your dreams with characters. Why are dreams so weird? It probably has to do with metaphors we use in our speech and thoughts every day. They may become literal when you turn off the logical parts of your brain. And the next thing you know, you're seeing pigs fly in your dream. What do dreams mean? Well, it mostly depends on the individual, but experts link some reoccurring themes to real-life problems and events. Being improperly dressed in a dream usually means the fear of being unprepared for something. Falling can signal anxiety and feeling out of control. Failing an exam in a dream may mean you're taking too much upon yourself and are stressed out. As for flying, you're feeling a lot of freedom and hope about something in your life. There's no such thing as a dreamless night. In fact, we see several dreams in one night. Your sleep comes in phases, and those can be one of two types, REM or non-REM. That stands for rapid eye movement, and yes, your eyes are moving around really fast when you're in it. Most dreams happen during the REM phase of sleep. You go through several of those in one night, each being longer than the one before it. Then, why is it so hard to remember dreams? Well, the part of the brain that helps form memories falls asleep last, and it may be the last to wake up. It takes up to 2 minutes after you've already awake for this part to take action. But by then, you've already forgotten most of your dreams. Other dreams are just reflections of mundane activities, so they aren't memorable. You can train yourself to remember your dreams. In the morning, make a note about your dream in the first 2 minutes after you wake up. Handwrite those notes with pen and paper to deepen the effect. No gadgets. With time, you'll be writing more and more details. It's also easier to remember dreams on weekends because longer nights of sleep mean more and longer REM phases. Can blind people see dreams? Dreams are usually visual, but people blind from birth still have dreams filled with sounds, voices, and even smells. People who lost vision at some point in their lives see visual dreams, but they fade with years. The parts of their brain that process visual information becomes less active with time. Blind people who train their brains to recall how things look can see better in dreams. Can dreams help you learn better? Absolutely. It has to do with the brain sifting through that information and storing the data it needs. During one study, people tried to memorize the map to a maze on a computer. Those who took a nap after that were able to go through it quicker and with fewer mistakes. Can dreams make you more creative? Many ideas got fully formed in their creators' dreams after they'd spent many days thinking intensively about them. Still, something was delaying that eureka moment. This something went off in their sleep, and great ideas, like the periodic table of elements or the sewing machine, came to life. What about a way to avoid nightmares? Remembering and analyzing nightmares can help drive them away from your dreams. For example, you often see yourself falling in a dream. After a thorough analysis, you'll remember this nightmare when you see it next time. With that, you'll be able to change the outcome of events and take control. For example, start flying or land on a giant gummy bear, whatever your brain comes up with. Is there a difference between nightmares and night terrors? If you suddenly wake up from a bad dream covered in sweat, you might have had a night terror and not a nightmare. They happen when alarms in your mind go off while you're going from light to deep sleep. At this moment, your body is awake, but your mind isn't. Night terrors usually happen at the same time each night, so it's possible to prevent them. Experts say you can set an alarm 30 minutes before this time to reset your sleep. Can you make yourself have good dreams? Things you think about before falling asleep have a big impact on what your dreams will be like. To have good dreams, avoid thinking about work or whatever's bugging you. Better think about distant places you always wanted to visit. Sounds, such as white noise, waves, or rain, are also good dream inducers if they aren't loud. The smell of lavender will help you sleep calmly too. Nighty-night!